That's when I put on my makeup and drown in self-hatred. Forget what I'm saying. Where'd the beat go? Oh, ain't that something? Drums came in, you ain't see that coming. Hands on my head, can't tell me nothing. Got a taste of the fame, it upon my stomach. Throw it back up like I don't want it. Wipe my face, clean up my vomit. All right, what is going on YouTube? Flame is the name. And today we are just going to be talking about the PC that I have. A lot of people have went back to my video or have like just seen the video of me unboxing my Digital Storm Lynx 1 PC, and I get a lot of questions and comments and stuff on it that I guess I didn't say in the video, but basically this is going to be a brief explanation on how the PC works and, you know, everything about the PC that I guess I wasn't stated in the video. Or people ask about the FPS and stuff they will get if they do get it. But I've upgraded my graphics card since then, so everything's a lot different. And I basically won't know what games like you guys want to know about unless I've played them already. Whenever I had the first, when I had the PC at first, I'm gonna pull up the stuff. So this is not the PC. Everybody thinks this is the PC, and then they're like, "Where's the graphics card?" This has a GeForce RTX, I think 2070 in it. The one that I have does not. So this right here, I don't know why they have the Lynx Model 1 right here. And then they have, this is the Model 4, I'm pretty sure. But the Model 1 does not have a graphics card in it. It has integrated graphics card. So that's something that nobody really knows. The Model 1 is the one I have. It's only $700. I think it comes out to be like $753. The estimated ship date is not 5 to 10 business days. It literally took me, I think, almost 2 months to get it. Processor. The processor is really good. AMD Ryzen 5 34G. I wouldn't say really good. It's only got 4 cores, but it does the job. The motherboard, it only has 2 RAM slots, sadly, but I think it's pretty decent for the PC and, you know, the amount of money you pay for it. But you can always, don't, I messed up. I should not have bought a pre-built. If you know somebody that can buy or build you a PC, please just buy parts, because it's so much better to do than buy a pre-built. RAM, it has 8 gigs of RAM. And for some reason, I have 2 6 or 2 8 gigs in my drawer in there, and I can't put them in here to make 16 gigs. I don't know why. It's really weird. Definitely compatible. It's both DDR4. It's so stupid. I don't know. The power supply is good, I will say. It will support up to a 2070 graphics card. So as I was saying, the Digital Storm Lynx 1 does not, I repeat, does not have a graphics card in it. It has integrated graphics. If you don't know what integrated means, integrated basically means that it's already built in with the, like, the graphics, basically. So there's no actual graphics card. It's just in the PC, and it's not good. It's not something you want. You don't ever want integrated graphics card. It's not good at all. The cooling stuff's fine. Cable management's fine. The RGB is pretty good. That really covers everything, but what I mainly wanted to talk about mostly was the FPS, because a lot of people have, like, questioned me about it. Once I first got the PC, I didn't know how bad or good it would be. Games I play Rainbow Six Siege. I don't really play Fortnite. I have Fortnite, but I don't really play it that much. I didn't play it whenever I had the integrated graphics card. I play it now that I have a new one. I don't know what the graphics you will get on Fortnite are. I apologize. But Rainbow, if you play on low settings, which most games you will literally have to play on low settings. There are not many you will play on high if you have the integrated graphics still. Low settings, I was getting around like 80 frames, which is, I mean, pretty decent. But you can't see anything because the graphics are so bad and so low. One thing to note is that if you don't have a 144Hz monitor or anything above 60, then you will not need to run a higher refresh rate than 60, which I'm pretty sure it will cap it by itself. But there is a way you can get more FPS, which is what I was doing, but I didn't realize that I was wasting, like, I was using more power in the PC than I needed to because I could only get 60 frames. But now that I have a 144Hz monitor and a new graphics card, it's a lot better. But if you need to upgrade to 144Hz, definitely do it, because it's just so much better. Most games, if you run on low settings, you can get up to 60 frames. Most of them cap at like 50, 55. Not like cap, but they normally can run around 55. It's really just not good. You definitely need to upgrade your graphics card. It's really sad how bad it is. GTA, really good game to play. You could run this one at 60 frames. I don't know why GTA is not that hard to run, but it really wasn't. You definitely have to play on like really low settings. Like there can be no anti-aliasing or, you know, any of that good stuff. Minecraft, honestly, Minecraft was hard to run on 60 frames. I actually didn't really even get 60 frames. And I was playing on shaders though. I had a lot of like good looking stuff, so it was kind of difficult to run. COD, Modern Warfare, one of the popular games. If you want to play COD and get this PC, you literally cannot. For some reason, they literally developed the game to where you cannot open the game with having integrated graphics cards. It will give you a DirectX, I think 11 error, and it will say, it won't say anything about integrated graphics cards, but you look into the research and it'll say, well, anybody that has integrated graphics cards cannot play the game. So I had wasted $60 for about 3 months, bought the game like really early, and when I had my integrated graphics card, and I literally couldn't even play the game. So I was very, very miserable. I was upset. There's just things you got to look into before you like start buying other stuff. The graphics card I have now, I have a Red Devil RX 590. It goes compatible with this PC really well. It runs things really well. Most things get over 144 hertz if you run them on high settings. It's really good. The next thing I'm probably going to upgrade will be either my RAM or my motherboard so I can have more RAM slots. Like I said, I would much rather you guys buy a bunch of parts and just get it built, because it's really not worth paying $700 for this PC when you can pay $700 for something literally that would knock this out of the water. Like it's just not a good buy. But I was impatient and I didn't know how to build one myself. I did have friends that knew how to build one, but I didn't feel like waiting, so I just bought this one. And it took so long to get, I don't know why it took so freaking long, but it literally took probably 2 months to get shipped and stuff. If you guys haven't seen my unboxing videos, you probably should go watch that one as well. But this is mainly for the people that want to know about the FPS and how the PC runs and everything. I still have problems when I open up Streamlabs and I'm playing games. I still get FPS lag. Well, it doesn't say I have FPS lag. Like, I'll have 100 and something frames, but it'll just give me FPS lag. So it's not, I don't know what the deal with that is. If you guys do know that, please tell me in the comments. I really have no idea what that is about. I guess this is all the video consists of. Like I said, this was mainly just for people that have been asking me questions on my unboxing video. Hope you guys did, you know, understand everything I was trying to say in this video. If you have some more questions, just drop them in the comments or go to my unboxing video and tell me stuff in there, whatever you guys want to do. But hope you guys did enjoy this video. Be sure to leave a like and subscribe if you are new, and it has been Flame, and I'm out.